so much to say in so little time.
Isaac's trash at handball.
It's my childhood here. This is all we know, so it's going to be a big change. I'm prepared for the real world. But it was good. It's been good while.
It's been pretty good. Only been here since year 10, but, you know, made some good friends, had a good time. Keen to graduate, though.
School's been great. Year 12, last. Gonna miss it.
Yeah, no, not too bad, eh? Amazing. So good.
Honestly, I don't remember the last 3 years. I remember up to like grade 11 or 12, that's about it.
Yeah.
The social side.
Yeah.
No, going out on the weekend and then coming back and telling everyone about it.
The toilet, I don't know. I don't know. All the people, I guess. Mr. Storsborn.
Cards I'd miss too much, but it is going to be pretty boring sitting at home every day unless I have uni.
The people.
Nacho Friday.
The people. I'm not gonna miss not having to wear socks and stuff like that.
I said orgasm instead of organism in year 9 in front of class.
Tripped over that wall in front of everyone.
No, we're smashing it. Dude, it's gonna be
embarrassing thing I've done. I don't know, I don't really get embarrassed that easy. Maybe walking into a wrong class every now and again.
I got hit in the head by a bow in when first free dressed. I feel like I'm in a job interview.
What will you remember the most about
by a boomerang?
Yes! I nearly got hit by a boomerang. Christian Ridd knows that.
Bert Armour.
Ribbon. Roach Nest. No, you have to say Thornborn. She sounds real well.
Yeah, but nice to
get old. I'm not sure if I can have one, but the Storsborn.
Take it back, that's mine.
Did a good job this year.
Storsborn.
I appreciate it.
God, I love it. Easily Miss Storsborn. Easily.
Larkin, for sure. Yeah.
Huh? Mr. Platt, for sure.
Mr. Platt.
Mr. Platt.
Mr. Platt.
Yeah, I've been by Mr. Bentley for where I
get you. Bad gal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bad gal.
Yeah. It's all good.
I went to Mr. Pester. I don't know what I did. I can't really remember.
Fake people here and there, but yeah,
the struggles. That's it's. I don't know. It's cooked, but it's good. It's a cooked good.
Many pathways to those show.
The people.
No, what? Many pathways to those show.
Boys get wet when it rains.
All the year 12s had like beards and were like 6 foot, huge.
That's really scary.
I was sitting in the big hall in front of everyone else. I didn't know a single person.
Fudo.
I had no friends at all. Everyone that I was friends with in primary saw me and went, see ya. So this is to you. See ya.
Playboy, billionaire.
What do I say in the future? I just don't want to be like an architect or a lawyer, but at the moment, I don't know, I wouldn't mind running a gym or something.
Stripper.
Thanks for the interview, guys.
I will miss your energy, whether you're taking it away from me or giving it to me. I'll miss
charisma.
Yeah, look, I'll just miss entertainment. I miss how much fun we have.
The humour.
Yeah, I miss the fun. You crack me up sometimes. So. You guys leave and then I sit in here and go, oh my god, that was so hilarious.
Oh, it's the individuality of these students. Sometimes it's too individual. Yeah. Most of the time, yeah, they're pretty gorgeous.
Jasmine Bauer.
Your energy and your sincerity and your just the love you give and the way you love each other, because you just make me feel hopeful for the world, because you are really connected and you've got a sense of integrity as a whole group. I feel optimistic for the world.
Oh my god, you're melting my heart.
Adoring?
No, the fact that you guys are all fun and the fact that you...
Oh, sense of humour, wonderful bunch of young people, hey? Sydney Barnett laughing at my bad dad jokes that she doesn't find funny. All kinds of things.
Oh, I will definitely miss how crazy and bouncy and spontaneous they absolutely are, and how smart they are.
And friendly.
I think I'm just going to miss having them around, because they were here in the first year that I started Benora. They were in year 9, and they're the cohort that I think I've known the best since I've been here. So I'm just going to miss seeing their little faces around, seeing them every day.
They're very friendly.
I will miss my beautiful drama students and my English students. I'll just miss them. I've had some of them for years, and my care class. I've had them for 3 years.
The thing I'll miss about the year 12 cohort is probably just not your mark. You'll come up in another question. Probably the thing, the reason I like year 12 is most of you are adults or adulting, and I can have a lot of conversations with you and make jokes with you and just hanging out, not just teaching. That's probably
don't cry.
The
most thing I want.
All I miss, probably the humour. It's one of the funniest cohorts I've had, I think. Bit of the banter, yep.
I'll miss everything about this year 12 cohort. This year 12 cohort, because I've taught so many of them, a lot of them in year 8, and my year, this group here that I had partway through last year and all of this year, that it's just a great cohort with so many really neat young people in this cohort.
I think they're such lovely young people, and I think that you've had a strong sense of service in the time that you've been here. I've watched the way the 12s have worked with the incoming 7s. I guess all of the different leadership type roles that the grade 12s have played, they've just been wonderful role models for, I guess, the whole school, and I've really appreciated the work they've done.
Oh, the constant banter, the constant me walking around the school and hearing, it hardly gets annoying at all. I'll miss that a lot.
I think all the friendly faces and all the little conversations that we have, little chit chats and stuff like that.
I've been teaching here 10 years, and this cohort is by far the most well-adjusted, wonderful cohort that I've ever taught, and so I'll miss all of you. I'll miss you so much.
Who?
The year 12 cohort.
Who?
29. What really bugs me is not taking responsibility for the bad things that are happening to yourself, or you complain about whatever's going on. And sometimes that just bugs me. It's like, what are you complaining about? You know, there's nothing wrong. That annoys me sometimes.
Firstly, I hate lying of any cohort, but I don't like disrespect. So I like it when we can communicate and stuff and people are individual, but when it goes too far, Nick, when it goes too far, sorry, when it goes too far, then I really don't like it. But what I love is everything else. Everything.
What do I hate about them?
Yeah.
Oh,
or dislike.
Or dislike.
Sometimes they don't always wash up their cups after I let them have a little secret cup of tea.
Oh, yeah, we don't wash up.
But that, they don't always wash up. Do you know what? There's nothing.
You don't know how to be quiet. What do you need to be? Actually, serious answer. The fact that when I asked you guys what you want to do next year, you got no idea.
Absolutely nothing to hate about the Year 12s. Outstanding bunch of young people. What can you say?
That they're leaving, that we'll miss them, and that they're awesome dancers, and that I've enjoyed every moment of watching them dance.
That's true. Wonderful dancers.
Wonderful.
Laziness. Funny, you should ask Tom.
Aw, that's a terrible question. No, these are a really great, you're a great cohort. I don't hate or dislike them at all.
What do I dislike about the Year 12s? Oh, look, that's really hard to answer because personally, I don't have any issues with any of our Year 12s. I think as a cohort, they settled in well for the year. I think they've led the school well. I honestly couldn't think of anything I would say to you that was you know, like a World War III or a disaster issue for us this year. It just hasn't happened. And that's because I think the young people now in Year 12 are a wonderful reflection of their families and of this school, and we're very appreciative of that.
Nothing I hate or dislike about.
About, I don't know if I hate.
Too many
hate's
drafts.
A strong word. Maybe if some of your drafts could have been a little better. Or completed at all.
I don't know about it. Hate's a very strong word. There's nothing I hate about the Year 12s.
Huh?
I think maybe the thing that I find most frustrating is the amount that the guys like to touch each other. I don't know if that's...
What do I hate about them or the cohort? Unexplained absences.
Mainly how ugly they all are. their faces and even their ugly personalities. But what a wonderful group, you know, collectively.
Couldn't be a possible thing that I hate. There was a time that I was a little disappointed though. In class one time, TK tried to tell me that Drake was a better rapper than Eminem. A little part of me died that day that the future of, you know, the young people coming through thought such ludicrous things, so that was a little disappointing.
We've had great growing years.
They're Year 12.
Jay. Yeah, I think there's slight competition there, but we'd have to go with McNatty, Jay McNatty. Some of the things, he's got no filter. Some of the things he says, it's like, you're kidding me, buddy.
Starts with C. Cooper.
Biggest goose in my class, well clearly that is me.
Righto.
That can't be, there's no other, no one beats me for class clown in any class I teach. These guys know.
Where shall I start? It can't be Chris Sedioioso because he's right here. It could be... Could be all of them combined.
Yeah. In different ways.
Yes. Everybody takes their turn at being the goose.
The biggest goose in our class is probably Eric. And he's not even that much of a goose. If it was in my other Year 12 class, I could list hundreds. Jackson McInnes, Julian Turnham, Jackson Smith, Hunter Ratti, lots of them.
Oh, goose. Oh, I'd like to say Oliver. Sorry, Oliver.
Goose. I don't think your student is geese or goose.
Biggest goose. I don't know if I need to say his name out loud. I think he knows. Oliver.
Oh.
Thank God.
Jacob Arnold. Yeah. Straight up. He's not even in my class. But, He's living proof that you don't need a long neck to be a goose.
I could all attribute a different type of animal to each. So the goose would definitely be the D-Max, David McAlane. Yeah.
The dumbest reason, I think it's because they left the class. They shouldn't have, I don't know. They just got, I don't know.
I haven't sent any this year.
Oh, really?
In this class, no, I've been pretty blessed. I've been pretty lucky. Despite the fact that I had jubes chucked at my head and rulers.
I haven't sent too many kids in the RTR, but I saw some good ones when I was down there. Saw some good ones on pieces of paper, where young people walk in with pieces of paper. So I probably shouldn't give too much away, actually. It's what goes on in the RTR stays in the RTR.
Right. Spent a good 15 minutes of a lesson not realising that one of the students was in a cupboard. So I think I ended up sending him to the RTR, that would probably be good.
I haven't sent anyone this year, but I came very close to sending someone for touching someone else, inappropriately.
I sent a student to the RTR once for stealing my laptop and running away. But apparently he should have just been sent straight to the deputy.
I can't see your white socks. That's really a pain in the neck. It's, you know, quite annoying.
Usually because of my own insecurities at being able to deal with that shit. Professional. So I'll be like, get out because you're better than me.
'They don't do homework.
What? No.
Just answer.
Every Tuesday I do playground duty with you guys in your area, and not one of you annoys me. Mind you, not one of you know the rules to handball, but yeah, that or I'm old. Pick one.
Not enough crazy sock days, clearly. Not enough crazy hair days. Maybe we need to do that next year.
It's going to have to be the laziness again. Not all year 12s, not all year 12s, but a lot of year 12s get a bit lazy, so that's my reason
for keeping them. I'm a peeve that I don't think the senior area is big enough for them. I think that year 12 cohort should have like a really nice place to gather. Maybe that's something for the future. Yeah.
Pit hate about the year 12. I had no pit hates about the year 12.
Right.
I'd probably have to say white socks.
I just don't think it's fair to make Jean-Marc represent the whole cohort, but I'd still say Jean-Marc.
The thing that wasn't necessarily used to, at the start of this year I had 23 girls in my class. Oh. I'm literally sick and tired of hearing about makeup, formal dresses, and partners to go and take, and after parties. Right?
He's sick of it.
Yeah, I've had enough. I want to talk about
he's had enough.
I want to talk about football, Ashes, and possibly the Melbourne Cup.
Ooh.
Sorry about all the ugly talk before, but it would be definitely that how all the SportX guys are so good looking and have better legs than me.
So save your money, have fun, but keep it in check, look after yourselves, and work.
Well, the major thing I want to say is good luck and use your personalities, because you guys have amazing personalities and that will always win over in the working stakes. People want people with something to say, with a personality that's interesting. Make sure you also know a lot about the world, because that makes you a more interesting person. General knowledge is important. I think stay in the light. Stay in the light and keep shining your light. And make some choices that are going to allow you to reach your potential.
Live a long, happy, peaceful life. Rock on.
Beautiful.
Go see the world. Go see the world. Get out there and travel the world. You'll never regret it.
Work hard, follow your heart.
Choose people.
Be kind to your friends. Choose life. Safe.
Be brave.
Be brave. Don't make silly choices. You know, look after each other. Look after your friends.
I think just keep being yourselves. Keep being true to yourselves. Don't try and change to fit in or be anybody that you're not.
Yeah, just be careful with your choices and stay healthy and happy.
Look, I think that you grow up with a whole range of dreams, and as you get older, sometimes you lose sense of those dreams you had. And what I would say to you is, you know, keep dreaming, but more importantly, don't you ever, ever, ever let anybody steal your dream. It's your dream. You make everything you can to happen to make it happen for you.
Absolutely, absolutely. So for me, life is like a fast break in indoor basketball. Yeah. If you're not the point guard in control and bringing the ball down the court, then just run the lanes, run hard, cut to the basket, and life will see you well at the end of it. Just do your best. Be hard. Listen, just all the best to all those year 12s that I've taught, all those year 12s that I've coached in basketball, had anything to do with. All the best to you all. It's been a pleasure.
Look, follow your dreams. If you work hard at anything, you can generally achieve it. So, yeah, good luck.
Not really, just life is really short. I still have to do just like me. And so you really have to make the most of it every day. We're going to miss you, and we're still here if you need us.
All right.
I think any advice I give you is, I don't think school is the most important thing. I think what you learn in school, it's more about how you learn, and you just take those skills. Everyone can do whatever they want. You can follow whatever dreams you want. I know I've talked to a few of you already, and I know you'll go on and do great things. So.
Philosopher Suarez.
Okay, so I'd like to say that I've enjoyed the whole experience the last 2 years, and that it was quite a challenge, but a really enjoyable one. And the fact that life's too short, so if there's something that you want to do, you need to go out and do it. Don't waste time, don't make excuses. Trust me. Yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank you, Miss.
Beautiful, thanks, Miss.
Don't do flacker. Right? It's bad, don't do it. Stay away from flacker.
Need a long block on the spot.
We get it almost every night.